Yo, what is going on, guys? Hope you guys have a great day. In today's video, as you guys can finally see, I've been hyping this video up for a bit in the past two videos that I've done. I've been saying that I was going to make a video on how to find the perfect sense. In my opinion, there isn't really such thing as a perfect sense in a way, because you will always make some mistakes and you always make changes depending on how, you know, well you play, or, you know, when you need to feel like you're going to start changing your style. So in my opinion, there is no perfect sense because there will always be mistakes in life. But in today's video, I'm going to help you guys figure out what kind of sensitivity you guys will need to use for your own play style. But before the video starts, make sure you guys follow me on Trovo and get the app. I don't know if you guys saw my announcement yesterday on Discord and my YouTube channel. I said that at 7 p.m. EST, which is Eastern Time today, which is the day you guys are watching this video, I will be playing with a bunch of you guys, which are the viewers, obviously. So feel free to download the Trovo app, follow me on Trovo, and wait till 7 p.m. EST when I start my stream, and you guys are going to have the chance to play with me. So yeah, other than that, hope you guys do enjoy the video. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and sub, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace. Alright guys, and welcome back to the video. So before we do start off with the video, I'm going to go through with you guys with the basics of sensitivity. So the basic with this is one of three things. The first one being the play style that you have. So before we start off with the video, play style has a huge thing to do with sensitivity. If you are an AR player, you're gonna want to use a slow sensitivity. If you're an SMG player, you're gonna want to use a fast sensitivity. And if you are a sniper, you would want to use in between. The reason for this is because sometimes you want to flick really hard to, you know, reach an opponent, and then sometimes you want to flick, not really flick, but move your, you know, crosshair like a bit towards the right or left, up or down, to get the enemy that is really close and charging you. So that is the first thing. The second thing is knowing what kind of sensitivity player you are. There are three kinds. The first one is fixed speed, the second one is distance acceleration, and third one is none other than speed acceleration, which is what I use, and which is a bunch of, it is also the sensitivity preset that a bunch of snipers and SMG players use, like myself, Little B, Godsley, and more. The third thing I was going to tell you guys about is knowing how to use this sensitivity match with your current movement that you use right now in game. Alright guys, so up first, we got an SMG player. The reason why I'm starting off with this is because this is the one I have the most experience with, knowing that I am a main SMG player. As you guys know, I only use the RUS, Cordite, QQ9, I used to use the MSMC, and, you know, all the other SMGs that you can think of that were meta back then, even the GKS I actually used. But with the recent changes, I haven't been really using some of those guns a lot, like the GKS, for example, that has been nerfed and can't really compete with the other SMGs like the RUS, Cordite, or QQ9. And I don't really use the one other SMG that I would actually use, which is known as really OP back then, which was known as the Pharaoh. I hope they do something with that gun to make it more OP, but most likely they're nerfing all the SMGs that you guys saw with Bobby's video. The reason for this is because SMG, well, this is what I think at least. SMG has been a meta for a while now, and I don't think there has been a meta in a season in ages that has been, like, you know, mixed with SMG, AR, and, you know, different kind of metas. So I think this is their way of, you know, diverting for that. But yeah, other than that, let's get on with the video. We're kind of getting off track there. But the reason why you need to use high sensitivity with SMGs, particularly, you know, close range guns like the, you know, MSMC or the QQ9, is because whenever you play as an SMG player, you're gonna want to play close range battles only. Not really only, but, you know, most of your battles should be close range to mid range, because SMGs do the most damage close range and mid range. If you try to go for a long range battle, that could possibly work, but with the recoils that SMGs have today, I don't think it's possible unless you're using the RUS or the Cordite. Anyways, the reason why you'd want to have a high sensitivity is because as you're rushing with it as an SMG player, you're going to want to flick really hard, or, you know, turn around really fast as you're going towards enemies. The reason for this is because, let's say you are going past an enemy and you slide in behind them, you're going to have to, you know, turn around really quickly as an SMG player and get those first few shots in due to you, you know, doing the most damage close range. If you don't do this, the enemy can unfortunately, you know, I mean, the enemy can eventually just, you know, turn around themselves and just shoot you, and you can end up dying. Now, This also leads to playing aggressive with movement. SMGs, as you guys know, is a lot to do with movement, and you gotta have good amount of movement that can, execute some orders and get some kills with your gun skill. If you don't think you have good enough movement with SMGs, I would recommend starting off small with an AR, and then as you get good with an AR, start moving towards SMGs to get more movement base. That's how I started out in the first place of me starting out COD Mobile in the beginning, since the Australian beta and the Canadian beta. But as I progressed harder, more and more, I ended up getting better towards my movement, which is when I started using SMGs. And with that being said, my first SMG I ever used was the RUS. Up next, we have the AR sensitivity presets. So with ARs, I would recommend using low sensitivity. The reason why is because with an AR, you're not really pushing as much as you are in an SMG player. So it is perfectly fine for you to use a low sensitivity, because with an AR, you're gonna most likely be playing from range and playing from head glitches, and you're going to want to have a low sensitivity to track your opponents really easily as they're sliding across the map or using their movement to their advantage and trying to dodge your bullets. And with the low sensitivity, you can track them even more, because you're not going to panic with your aim and start moving left and right as fast as you shouldn't be doing, if that makes sense, especially if you have speed acceleration. The last and final kind of sensitivity class we have is known with the snipers. With snipers, you never know what situation you're going to be in, so I would 100% recommend using speed acceleration mixed with a middle class sensitivity. Now, it is personal preference on which kind of sensitivity you don't want to use. I wouldn't recommend copying someone. Go with what you feel is comfortable, but with speed acceleration, it is most likely needed to play with snipers, because you never know if you're going to want to flick really hard to kill someone, or if you just need to move your crosshair your screen a bit to get the kill that you need. Now that we are talking about what playstyle your sensitivity should match with, let's get on with what each sensitivity means. So basically, with fixed speed, it is a default number 120, and with fixed speed, it basically means the more the slower or faster you move your screen, it will always be the same at any swipe of your screen. So let's say I swipe my screen really fast from left to right. That will always be the same as me, swiping my screen left to right slowly. Let's say I take 5 seconds to swipe my screen left to right slowly, and it takes 2 seconds for me to swipe it really fast. It will always be the same speed. Up next, we have the one called as distance acceleration, which I do not recommend that many people to use because how inconsistent it is. With distance acceleration, it basically means the longer you put your finger on the screen, the faster it goes. And with this being said, you never know how long you're putting your finger on the screen, or if you're putting it there by mistake. So let's say you put your finger on the screen by mistake because you play claw and you end up trying to go for a swipe. It may be really fast to the point where you just mess up your aim and you start panicking and you just lose the gunfight. So in my opinion, I would not really recommend using distance acceleration. I would go more for fixed speed or speed acceleration, which is the one I'm going to talk about next. Now, the last and final sensitivity preset that I have for you guys is known as speed acceleration. A lot of people use speed acceleration. Doesn't matter if they are an AR player, an SMG player, or a sniper player. Personally, this is my kind of my favorite sensitivity, because at points, if I want to have slow sensitivity, I don't really have to swipe my screen as fast, so I can control my aim way more properly and stably. You guys know what I mean. It's way more stabilized than me, just swiping my screen really slowly and the same consistently if I use fixed speed. Also, with speed acceleration, since it does mean the faster you swipe, the faster your sensitivity goes, this helps me a lot, especially since I use finger sleeves. If you guys know, finger sleeves are these things that basically make that you put on your thumbs or your aiming finger, and they make your fingers have the same consistency within the whole game. I've been using finger sleeves since I joined Omen, or midway between Omen, which is about 10 months ago, and since then I have not taken them off. Personally, I would buy probably a pair and see how it would fit, and see how much you guys feel about using them, but I wouldn't recommend everyone to buy it if you guys don't want to. The problem with buying finger sleeves is the moment you buy finger sleeves and you start using them, you're gonna have to change your sensitivity a lot. So be prepared for that. You don't think you can have the mental brain power to actually try and find a new sensitivity that's going to match you with finger sleeves. I would not recommend buying these because it will take you around 4 to 7 days to find the right sensitivity for you after switching from finger sleeves to no finger sleeves to finger sleeves. I'm sorry. But yeah, just keep that in mind when you guys do buy these. Also, the third tip I can actually give you, not really tip, but the third thing I can give you guys on sensitivity is play around with your sensitivity. Don't be afraid to lose or gain a few points with your sensitivity presets. Let's say, you know, you end up firing your gun and you seem, you know, it feels like the sensitivity is too slow. Don't be afraid to, you know, tone it up a notch and increase it by a few points as you go. And as you guys do know, COD Mobile is all about making minor changes to make yourself better. So don't be afraid to do this, especially if it's going to affect your gameplay in a bad or good way. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and sub. And I hope you guys in the next one. Make sure you guys download Trovo and follow me on the app. Because today at 7 p.m. EST, I will be playing with you guys. But other than that, I hope you guys have a good rest of your day or night, whichever time you're watching this video at. Peace out.